In the gardens of the graceful old white houses in New England, you will sometimes see a little summer house, usually built on a rise in the ground so that anyone sitting in it of a summer evening can command an extensive view. These pretty little fancies are called gazebos.
My father was a banker, the richest man in town. He left me with a fortune, but no mate. Though I've practiced all the wiles employed by ladies of renown, I've gotten no results until of late. So I built myself a summer house, a peekaboo affair, the footpath that the village passes near. And any pleasant evening when you are strolling there, this is what you'll hear. If you peek in my gazebo as you are passing by, you will see a sight that will delight the most fastidious eye. If you peek in my gazebo, you'll no longer be a freebo. If you think that you will be, oh, why not try? The village boys go strolling when summer nights are fine, though what they're looking for I wouldn't know. But the path they choose for strolling on is generally mine, and their steps are very loitering and slow. And in behind my lattice work I sing my gentle song. It melts the most recalcitrant and gruff. It isn't necessary that you hesitate for long. One peek in my gazebo is enough. If you peek in my gazebo as you are passing by, you will see a sight that will delight the most fastidious eye. If you peek in my gazebo, you'll no longer be a freebo. If you think that you will be, oh, why not try? Good evening. I've not acquired a husband, but I am reconciled. Devoted friends mean so much more to me. I can't regret the hours so agreeably beguiled in building up my pleasant coterie. No wonder I can hardly wait for dark to come along. At every aperture a boy is found. And as I serenade them, there's just one thing that's wrong. There aren't enough peepholes to go around. If you peek in my as you are passing by, you will see a sight most fastidious eye. If you peek in my gazebo, you'll no longer be a freebo. If you think that you will be, oh, why not try? Eh? Hmm?